Hi, Harry here for the rant on February 9th. I am way up in Whistler, Canada, speaking at the Tony Robbins Platinum Partnership Conference. They do four a year. These are 500 to 600 of the most excitable people you will see. Very fun audience, very diverse. And I'm not a skier, so not my favorite place to go this time of the year in winter. But of course, Whistler is one of the nicest ski resorts in North America as well. So here we are on February 9th, Friday, and the markets are doing the same old thing. You know, are they gonna keep going up? You know, the large caps keep making slight new highs, but here's the key thing. The Russell 2000, the small cap index, would have to rally 24% for them to confirm the new highs in the S&P 500 and the NASDAQ 100, the two largest cap indices. And that is a classic divergence, folks. So the only problem is, you know, it would take a good while for the Russell 2000 to go and make a new high if it was going to do it. But it really doesn't look that likely, okay? So if this divergence continues and if stocks start to break down soon, which I think is the more likely scenario, then it probably does mean it looks like we put in a major top. And again, my key chart, and newsletter subscribers see this, I've been featuring it the most, the Russell 2000 has been trading in a very clear sideways channel. And so the top is around 2000-ish, and it just got up to 2059 recently. If it breaks above that, that is bullish near term. But if it breaks down and continues to break down, that will be more bearish. And then if it breaks 1630, so that's the number to remember on the Russell 2000. If we can break 1630 convincingly, that would really say this rally is over. This entire huge bull market of all time, and of course, you know my view, 100% funded by stimulus, not by demographics and fundamental strength. Even the tech, my 45-year technology innovation cycle peaked around 2020, and of course, the demographic generation cycle peaked around 2007. So all cycles are negative, all, and the Fed so overstimulated over COVID that they finally had to pull back and tighten 525 basis points. So folks, between now and early 2025, because of the year to year and a half lags in monetary policy, the truth is gonna be told. They have tightened the most in 40 years. I think that's gonna hurt, especially such a bubble overstretched economy, but we won't really know until we get later this year, and the stimulus should fully hit by early 2005. The tightening, okay? So really, I know this is tough because the markets keep edging up and stuff, but this is really a better time to be out or short for more aggressive investors. And even if I'm wrong here, the gains are limited after a rally this much, but you have to know that the downside is very, very high. Just to go back, and you gotta remember that, just to go back to the 2020 COVID lows, just a few years ago, would be about a 60% crash off of the highs for the NASDAQ and 50 to 55 for the S&P 500 and broader stocks. So this is a time where the downside greatly outweighs the upside. And you know, if we just continue to move sideways over 2024, it would kind of be bullish for the markets, but it would also still say very limited upside because markets are as high or the most overvalued as they can get in history. So good time to be cautious. And of course, I will keep you updated.